Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we'd like to welcome into the ring a very special guest performer, an Inglewood, California native, and rock family member. Please welcome Casey Veggies.
Yeah. Connecticut, y'all feeling good. I need to see everybody dancing in the crowd. Everybody turn up, everybody sitting up. I need to see y'all dancing. Let's get going.
Shit for the summer.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Everybody make some noise for Rock Nation Sports for putting this on one time. I go by the name of Young Casey Veggies from Los Angeles, California. DJ Don Beats, let's get into it, let's go. If you feeling good, put your hands up, what's up? Hey, 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 I see you over there, I see you. Yeah, I said I pulled up, stunned, head, everything waving. With pepper, 100 jeans, cross 580. Guess he won it, cause he acted so complacent. You can say I'm wrong, but I guess the boy crazy. Running, that's all I'm really saying. Hundreds, man, that's all I'm really paying. Lifestyle flows, man, that's all I'm really spraying. She caught me on the weekend, head straight to the deep end. We did, cross the hall from the morning to the evening. Make that girl clean it, make that girl sleep in. Turn me up, one time. This is my last song for the night. I got my debut album. It's called Live and Grow. It's dropping 2015. This is my first single. It's called Backflip. Let's have a party in here real quick. Drop it. Hey.
Make it do it, make it do a backflip.
What he say, huh? Everybody say it with me, huh? Let's go,
You wasn't really real. He was like, you knew your tone. Got him holy by the real. He said, hallelujah. Take my time, but it's coming in faster. My new chick better than my last hoe. Get money, I can put your mans on it. Don't talk about it, drop bands on it. I can turn your bitches to a fan on me. Young nigga hot, put a fan on me. I'm the man on me. I'm the man on me.
Young winner hot, put a fan on me.
Said I got a couple friends just like me. In front of Bay, hella thick and get hype. 12 months all about the cash flip. Let the money make it do a backflip. Let the money make it do a backflip. Do it for the team on the next shit. We should put money in the mattress. We do it on the time, no practice. I bet the money make it do it. I bet the money make it do it. Make it do a backflip. I bet the money make it do it. I bet the money make it do it. Make it do a backflip.
It's all love, let's get it. Swag, swag.
All right, thank you. Casey Veggies, his debut album coming soon with the hit record, Backflip. Now coming up, we're ready to do flips over these guys. Our main event, the Cruiserweights with the IBF Intercontinental Cruiserweight title on the line. Murat Gassiev, Felix Cora Jr. coming next. And welcome back to the Grand Theater at Foxwoods Resort and Casino, and we're ready for our main event. And this should be interesting, folks, out of the cruiserweight division. This kid, Murat Gassiev, he's undefeated with 14 KOs. They think that in the future, he could become a significant player in the heavyweight division. But right now, cruiserweight against the veteran, Felix Cora Jr. Time now to go inside the ring for the introductions. Here's John Venna.
Ladies and gentlemen, now entering your ring for the main event of the evening for the IBF Intercontinental Cruiserweight Championship, the challenger from Galveston, Texas, please welcome Felix Pat News Cora.
35 years old, Felix Cora, fighting out of Galveston, Texas. He was on the contender. He continues to fight with a 25-6-2 record, 14 KOs. He has to use his veteran savvy against Murat Gassiev.
Won three fights in a row, including a Latino title win. So he's hovering around 25-6-2. Comes off a win over Andre Carthon. Good vicious body shot, so he can surprise you now and then, but he'll be fighting against the age factor.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, entering the ring, the defending champion from Vladikavkaz, Russia, please welcome Murat Iron Gassiev.
Murat Gassiev, 21 years young, folks, undefeated, 20-0, 14 KOs. And as we mentioned at the top of our broadcast, Dave, they are bringing him along quickly, and they feel, Abel Sanchez, his trainer, that he has the mentality to handle it.
And he's done a nice job. One thing about that, he's already won a 12-round fight, which he did very early in his career for a continental title. That says a lot to a trainer. And his last five fights have got a total of 12 rounds. So he's gone short and he's gone long in the victory round.
He spent some time sparring with Vladimir Klitschko. And according to Abel Sanchez, he did well.
It's a good sign because he's going to be in that heavyweight division at some point.
So a look at the tail of the tape. Gassiev, Cora Jr. for the IBF Intercontinental Cruiserweight title, fighting 12 rounds.
Big number, the age, 35 versus 21. Can Gassiev make that a big factor? He's also got a little bit of a height advantage, but the first number there is the biggest. What about the rules of this contest? No standing eight count, no three knockdown rule. Fighter cannot be saved by the bell at all. Only the referee can stop the fight. Physicians have a lot to say. And you go to the scorecards after the fourth round in the case of an accidental foul.
All right, let's go back to John Vena.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Grand Theater here at Foxwoods Resort Casino, Rock Nation Sports, in association with Euro Promotions, proudly presents your Throne Boxing main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the IBF Intercontinental Cruiserweight Championship. This bout is proudly presented to you by Tap Out, Jaybird, Tequila, Cazadores, Techno Home, Puma, Venue Kings, Casa de Campo, and Andrea Professional, as well as Sparking Ice. Supervising at ringside for the IBF, the Honorable Eddie Cotton, and your three judges scoring from ringside on a 10-point must system are Bob Paolino, Waleska Roldan, and Eddie Scunzio. And your referee in charge of the action, Connecticut Boxing Hall of Famer Johnny Callis. And now, introducing the principals, fighting out of the red corner, the challenger. Wearing black with gray trunks, he weighed in at trim and ready, 198 pounds. His outstanding record reads 25 victories, only 6 defeats, with 2 draws and 14 big wins coming by way of knockout. A former WBO Latino Cruiserweight champion from Galveston, Texas, please welcome Felix Bad News Cora. And his opponent, fighting out of the black corner to my right, the defending champion, wearing white and red and weighing in at trim and ready, 197 pounds. Undefeated in 20 professional bouts with 14 big wins coming by way of knockout. It comes to us from Vladikavkaz, Russia, the reigning IBF Intercontinental Cruiserweight Champion, Murat Hayran Gassiev. Referee Johnny Callis with final ring instructions.
Felix, Murat, you received your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Above all, obey my commands at all times. First command is right now. Touch gloves and the bell rings box.
So here we go, folks. The cruiserweights, our main event. Gassiev versus Cora Jr. Gassiev, the young up-and-coming bull. Felix Cora, the older bull.
And he says, I have to be smart first. Didn't actually outline a strategy. Says he's going to try to do it on the fly.
He said he has to get in there to see what he wants.
Felix,
to
ready?
Definitely go to the body and try to frustrate the younger Gassiev.
So we've got the righty-lefty matchup here. So for Gassiev, the right-hand lead, as we saw in our last fight, double left hook, lead foot outside, the lead foot of Cora. Let's go!
Cora comes in with plenty of experience, 25-6-2 record, 14 KOs. you have the taller man at 6'3 and a half. Cora listed at 6 feet.
Gassiev had the typical prototype of the stand-up fighter coming in overseas, but Abel Sanchez is working with him, and you can see he's got a little bit more of a dip and a crouch, try to get more power. That's what they're trying to bring into it.
Uppercut to the body landed for Gassiev.
That was a good body shot by Gassiev.
Gassiev started boxing at the age of 15. Tried soccer, tried wrestling, went to the gym with one of his buddies one day and fell in love. And so far, the sport is falling in love with him at 20 and up.
He's pressuring here nicely, setting it up with the jab.
Cora Jr. circling, relaxed.
So some good firepower coming at him so far from Garcia. Good body shots and the left hook.
Cora Jr. 35, looks a little soft in the middle. Gassiev saying that he wanted to establish the body punching early on.
Well, that's one way you can really test a 35-year-old guy, and the other way is to make him use his legs. He's right on him.
You can see the experience of Felix Cora Jr. So relaxed. In a rush.
Gassiev doing everything he wants as far as controlling the round and setting a tempo. And that was a good glancing right hand off the temple area.
Sharp punching so far by Gassiev. Very compact. There's that right hand again. Cora with the straight left hand. End of the round. And we'll stay right here. Abel Sanchez, the trainer, for Murat Gassiev. Dwight Pratchett, for Felix Cora.
As he's moving, you cut him off. Step him back, bring him back in. But don't step this way. Step to him a little bit too, okay? Yeah. Don't just go this way. Gotta go forward so he has to change direction. Okay? And be ready when he changes direction.
That Gassiev talked about this morning coming right into the game plan. Double left hooks, gets in tight again. Not in a hurry for head hunting. He knows the body work will pay off sooner or later.
Round two, scheduled for 12 in the cruiserweight division. The IBF Intercontinental Cruiserweight title on the line. The champion in white, 21-year-old Murat Gassiev, taking on the challenger in black, Felix Cora Jr. Very good pace in the first round.
Yeah, and it was all Gassiev, and you get the sense that Cora is going to try to put a little something into his attack here. He started out jabbing as if he got his assessment from the first round.
Here's that body shot behind the elbow. Money in the bank, fighters say sometimes. There it is again.
These are meaningful left hooks downstairs. They are terrific shots, and he sets it up. Even if the punches upstairs are being blocked, there's a rhythm for Gassiev, and then he right away dips in and fires that very hard left hook to the body. And when you watch Gassiev lean into these shots, it would not surprise you if he scored a knockout with a body shot.
So the left hook to the body, the dominant punch for Murat Gassiev to start the first two rounds. And if you look at the love handles of Felix Cora Jr., now he's starting to drop that right hand a little bit.
Dropping the right hand, he's got to have that elbow protect that sensitive area where he's been getting nailed with that left hook, and that's going to open up a left hook to the head. for Gassiev. This is a surgical breakdown so far.
Now, Cora Jr. going to the body himself.
Well, this has been a blistering pace set by Gassiev.
Gassiev pinning Cora Jr. in the corner, left hook up top, landing, then the left hook down low, straight right hand getting through for Gassiev. Oh, another devastating left hook, a left hand up top as well.
Doesn't look like a cruiserweight.
No, he doesn't. Heavy punches for the Russian. Vladikavkaz, Russia. Not bad with Abel Sanchez in his corner. Body head again for Gassiev.
And you can tell the Abel Sanchez ingredient in how Gassiev is attacking. He's not standing straight up. He is getting into these punches, and he is crouching, bending his knees, and getting full impact.
Another combination for Gassiev. Backs up Cora Jr. Closing moments of the second round. Punches and bunches now. Followed by a stiff right hand. Murat Gassiev. Impressive.
The Gassiev show center stage at certain parts of round two. Good hooks to the body. Upstairs. Jab gets inside, works through everything, and he has been piston-like with the quickness on a lot of those shots.
Third round, scheduled for 12. Murat Gassiev, the IBF Intercontinental Cruiserweight title from Vladikavkaz, Russia. 21 years old, undefeated at 20-0, taking on Felix Moore Jr., 35 years old. And so far, the left hook to the body behind the elbow has been the key punch for the Russians. Now, here's Cora Jr. answering with a nice three-punch combination of his own.
This is one time the fighter did not have to listen to the corner. He felt it first. Those body shots hurting Cora in rounds one and two. And the corner saying you've got to take that punch away from him. Well, what he has to do is move and get out of range for that.
Cora sitting down on his punches.
The numbers showing you the dominance of Gassiev, and there's another element too, and that's the intensity of those body shots that can't be measured in those numbers.
Ooh, to the midsection, the uppercut by Gassiev. And Cora Jr. felt that punch. Cora Jr. starting to let his hands go. A lot more, but he eats a three-punch combination, fires back with a right hook of his own.
One of the hardest guys to fight is anybody who has this kind of discipline to the body. Gassiev opened this fight as if someone had told him the head was outlawed, and he didn't care. He went right to the body and stayed there exclusively.
Cora, nice counter-punching off the ropes as he gets the fight back to the center of the ring. Great rhythm to this fight between these two cruiserweights. Both fighting inside and out. No holding, no grappling.
And if you're Cora, you've got a double jab as if everything depended on it to buy yourself some time. The problem if he wants to move, though, is that he's 35.
Stiff left. To the body. Or it seems like he's come alive here in the third round. He's told us during our fighter meetings this morning that I'm going to have to figure this big guy out when I'm in there.
And he's been true to that because he's weathered a lot in the first two rounds and has come up with at least something a little different in round three. A little bit of jabbing and some angles.
Body shots very effective for Cora Jr. His best round of the fight so far. Gassiev. So don't forget, folks, coming up soon.
He doesn't need to work.
on June 6th at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn, New York, defending his WBC middleweight world champion, the great Miguel Cotto, against Daniel Gale. Cotto could be headed to a clash with Alvarez. Canelo, only one loss to the great Floyd Mayweather Jr.
What a monster fight that would be.
Man.
Inside, don't end up
up. Murat Gassiev quickly off the stool as we head into the fourth round, scheduled for 12. Cruiserweights in the ring. Both weighed in at under 200 pounds. Yesterday. Cord Jr. in black, Gassiev in white. Cord Jr. coming off his best round, that being the third.
He's keeping the jab in the face of Gassiev, trying to buy a little space, trying to throw off the rhythm of the young Gassiev.
But he's backed Gassiev up with the uppercut and the straight left hand of the body. Sometimes body punchers don't like to be punched to the body. And look at Gassiev crouching when that left hand gets close.
And I think someone has the nerve to do what they're doing, to answer the body shot. And Gassiev strayed low a little bit. He continues to go to work, loading up those body shots for some type of a dividend. And then, when Cora had the body covered, he snaked in a right hand to the head.
Great left hand landing for Cora Jr. Gassiev answering. The straight right hand by Gassiev. A lot of body punches, a lot of inside fighting. It's been a beautiful thing to watch so far, folks. Now Gassiev with the left hook, connecting.
The problem for Cora is he can't move much, so he can't employ the strategy of making the ring bigger and making Gassiev work harder. He's trying to conserve energy, and that shortens the ring and makes it better for Gassiev.
Gassiev, though, looking to set up that left hook, which has been his dominant punch so far. Behind the elbow, tries to go up top. Ooh, a cracking right hook by Cora Jr.
And then a good uppercut by Gassiev.
There's that left hook behind the elbow again. When will it pay dividends? Or Junior. Seconds remaining, fourth round. Great action here in Massachusetts, Connecticut.
You're doing very, very well, okay, but I just want to see more combinations. You're throwing a nice hook down here, I want to see that hook followed by a hook on top. Two, quickly. And be ready for the uppercut with the right hand. Mm-hmm. There's got to be more than one or two punches. You got to put things together. Mm-hmm. Okay? You have to do it.
Huh?
On the head.
Okay.
You understand? Okay. So it's not one or two. Boom, 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 boom. Okay. All right. And then back off, jab, and do it again. Easy job out there.
Okay.
Don't leave it. I don't want to see the rest. There's no reason to rest here. Jesus lands a punching bag.
Well, Gassiev on the inside, nice uppercut. And then from the right hand, and the body shot, which has been his calling card. Cora doesn't know what to defend.
I noticed something. Felix Cora Jr., between rounds, mouth open, taking deep breaths. The body shots may be affecting him as we head into the fifth. Scheduled for 12, cruiserweight division. Murat Gassiev, the 21-year-old Russian in white. Felix Cora, the 35-year-old from Galveston, Texas, who trains out of Houston in black.
Look at how Gassiev gets everything into this. Gets in tight. Watch the hips and the leverage. Good balance. And then he's been ripping off the shots.
Cora Jr. not as active to start this fifth round. There's a body work by Gassiev. Cora Jr. wedged in the corner. Fights his way off. Uppercuts followed by a slapping right hand. Left hook up top, left hook down low for Gassiev. Now he punches through the guard of Felix Cora Jr.
He will not let Cora Jr. coast. Cora Jr. is trying to buy some time, but Gassiev is right on him. With a high percentage of power shots by Gassiev. They're short, they're compact, they're powerful, and they're on the mark.
Left hook again behind the elbow. Now the right hand, followed by a left hook up top. Beautiful boxing here, folks. These fighters giving and taking. Blood trickling out of the nose of Felix Cora Jr. A minute to go. Now Cora Jr. putting a combination together. Backs up into the rope, stumbles a bit. Are his legs going? Heavy hands for Murat Gassiev. Another uppercut to the midsection. Combination punching.
Well, he stays right on task and has set a tremendous pace.
Cora Jr.'s hand starting to slow down now. Bending over. Ten seconds to go. Fifth round. Scheduled for 12. Cruiserweight division. The young up-and-comer. Impressive so far against the veteran. Now, you know, Roc Nation has signed Miguel Cotto, who will be fighting on June 6th at the Barclays Center. And they scored another huge crew when they signed this man. Pound for pound, considered maybe the number two fighter in the world behind Floyd Mayweather Jr. Andre Ward returns to the ring on June 20th in his hometown of Oakland, California, with so many successful fights at the Oracle Center, including the Oracle Arena, rather, including the Super 6 beautiful classic.
I've done a number of his fights, and in Oakland, the city just stops when he gets for the weigh-in. They commanded the center of the city. He's a big draw, well-spoken guy, and it's going to be quite a June.
Come on, man, dude. We've got a great one here. Two fighters letting their hands go. Sixth round scheduled for 12 in the cruiserweight division. Felix Cora Jr. in black. Murat Gassiev, the Russian, in white. There's body work by Gassiev. Step straight back, though. Nice roll by Gassiev. The Jr. trying to use his jab, hooking off his jab. Gassiev splitting his guard, going down the middle.
When you want to know what separates fighters, it's work ethics like this. Gassiev right on it, going to work with three or four shots at a time, setting up shop every time he backs Cora up. Jumps on every perceived weakness and pours punches in there. And Cora, to his credit, hanging in, trying for new strategies. He's just getting overpowered.
And slowing down, another uppercut getting through for Gassiev. Not a lot on the punches for Cora. Although he has kept his hands busy. Now Cora breathing out of his mouth, a sign of fatigue. Garcia sitting down on the right hook to the body. Big right hand landing up top, followed by an uppercut by Garcia. Digs another left hook to the body. Now Cora answering as he splits with an up jab.
He just can't get out of harm's way because of the absence of movement, and then Gassiev is right on him.
Gassiev fighting him in the phone booth. Cora Jr. just trying to touch. Now shoe shine by Gassiev. I'll tell you what, Dave, we've seen two great fights tonight. Ray Robinson and Alimjanov fighting inside. Now these two big men.
And when you mentioned the phone booth, Cora's got to dial 911 based on what's been happening here, because it's been the guy right on top of him, and he's answering. I love the pace of these big guys. You know, you're used to seeing cruiserweights and heavyweights slow down in the middle of fights, but not these two guys.
Beautiful boxing. Gassiev left hook, double right hand to the body. Cora answers as he digs himself with the right hook. Now Cora backs up Gassiev, uppercut lands. Cora showing his veteran savvy. Breathing out of his mouth, waiting for his second wind to kick in here in the sixth round.
It'll be interesting to see what they tell him.
Now Cora staggered on that left hook at the end of the round, and he breathes heavily as he goes to see trainer Dwight Pratchett.
Crack his leg a little bit, that one. Lean back, lean back. Lean back. Let me work on it. Here, Dwight. Keep our back in real easy. Nice and easy. You can't sit there too long, again, okay? You gotta keep moving. You gotta throw them hooks on the inside, okay? They're gonna go through this trap.
More mayhem for Gassiev. That's the right hand to the head, which opened up after the body shots. And he has been married to that game plan, to the body, and it has worked beautifully for him.
Seventh round. Gassiev in white. Cora Jr. in black. Sweat flying as punches are exchanged by these two gentlemen. Right hook. Cora, right hook, left hand.
The numbers big for Gassiev, as they have been, and the intangible, the intensity of those body punches, which may not show up here, but they have shown up on Cora, and he has hung in there the best he can.
I'm heavy punches, triple left hooks, right hand. Cora's in trouble. Cora in trouble. They may stop it right now. Cora leaning over Gassiev, and Cora just explodes. That's hard. Fighting off the ropes. Now he backs up Gassiev. Hands down, may be hurt. Cora Jr. digging deep. Gassiev in trouble. Not answering.
From one punch away from being out to a turnaround like that, a terrific sequence.
Gassiev moves in, though. He's cleared his head. Straight right hand. Now he uses his jab. He wants to get that body shot off again. Gassiev pawing with the jab, followed by a stiff right hand. .105 to go. This kind of fight is what makes you fall in love with the sweet science.
Absolutely. With this type of work ethic from Gassiev and the resilience by Cora to fight back in the bleakest moment of this fight to come and find one more surge, which made this round what it was.
Felix Cora Jr., so much heart, refusing to go down. 28 seconds to go. They feel that they can bring Gassiev along quickly. That's why they threw him in the ring with this 35-year-old veteran. He's learning a lesson here. Cora doubling up the jab. Gassiev, mouth open now. He's tight. 8 through 12, folks, should be interesting.
You gotta keep bouncing, okay? Can't sit there, can't sit in one spot too long, okay? We gotta keep moving, okay? Keep
breathing in, okay?
Nice. Turn around, okay? See how you feeling, okay?
Back inside with something to bring him back in, okay? Doesn't matter. Jab a right hand right to the chest or to the belly. Make him close his hands. So that way you go back outside, okay? It's practice. Deep breath.
Couple different extremes. Gassiev trying to make what looked like closing arguments to the referee. Pouring it on Cora. Referee taking a good look in. Throwing everything at him, but Cora blocking enough of them and then comes surging back. And this was his best moments of the fight. A good right hand. He forgot about being lefty, and he just went with it.
Both fighters touching gloves to start the eighth round. Gassiev with a smile on his face as if he's saying, I'm learning as I go on. Thank you for this challenge.
Yeah. How could this guy still be here? The dominance in one aspect with the numbers, and he threw a handful at Cora Jr. last round trying to end it, and Cora extended him.
Gassiev also showing talent with the right hand. He's turning it over now. Cora Jr. on the ropes. Did he empty his tank in the seventh round is the question. Cora Jr. now bent over, leaning to the side.
A little surprised that Cora didn't stay righty. He had a good experiment with that round in the last round, going righty for a while. He could do enough of that maybe to distract Gassiev, but he went back into the lefty mode here.
Cora Jr. getting the fight back into the center of the ring. Gassiev going downstairs with the jab. Cora Jr. back in the corner. This is where Gassiev has done some of his best work. Gassiev pawing with the jab. Feigning. Cora turning. Now Cora unleashes. Cora, mouth open, leaving heaven. 35 years young.
There you go.
Johnny Callis has done a terrific job refereeing this fight. He's in the Connecticut Hall of Fame. He's let the two big men go at it.
And he gave Cora Jr. one last opportunity when he was being backed up. And Cora Jr. took advantage of it, came back. So the referee knowing exactly how much latitude to give these guys.
Cora Jr. when in trouble, knows how to fight out of the corner. Left hook by Gassiev. Gassiev now looking a little confused as if he doesn't know how to finish Corey Jr. There's a shoe shine left hook up top.
Confused, but not frustrated. We've seen guys who have been in that situation and can't finish the guy, and then they start to slow up and they get discouraged. His mantra is keep working.
Corey Jr.'s most effective punches tonight have been going to Gassiev's body with the straight left hand and the uppercut. He's gone away from it. Let's see if he can rediscover it. And you get the feeling that Corey Jr. is trying to time Gassiev. It won't happen now.
I think that was a two-way.
Good, good round. The only thing I don't want you to do is take too many unnecessary shots, okay? You let them throw right hand in a jab and hit you. I want to see you slip the shot, okay? Practice, dude. This is... Good, good round.
I need to show that. Look at that.
Good round, except for you letting them work a little too much. I don't want to see three shots.
Three shots.
You slip, counter. Okay, you went very good outside. And those jabs and right hands in the middle were working good. So let's do the round again. Okay? Same thing. It's just that when you do that, be prepared to throw a second shot. Doesn't matter here, doesn't matter where. All right?
Well, this is a good student-teacher relationship. And Abel Sanchez saying, don't give him too many free shots. Set up your second one. He's got Cora in the corner there. Nice jab in the right hand.
Murat Gassiev with only 20 fights. Undefeated. 14 KOs. Felix Cora Jr., different story. At 35, he's 25-6-2. So he brings a wealth of experience into this match.
And he's trying to extend Gassiev, who gives you the impression he's got the ferocity of a Kovalev or a Golovkin. Work ethic has been tremendous, not a backward step.
Big left hook, followed by a right hook to the body. And slowing down for Cora Jr., but he's able to marshal his energy and come up with surges when he needs it. Oh, left uppercut, backs him up to the ropes. And Hurdle. Oh, Cora Jr. in trouble.
Should have at least had a standing eight there, but you don't have the standing eight. Otherwise, you stop the fight.
And the fight will be stopped right now. Murat Gassiev finally figures out Felix Cora Jr. Gallant effort by Cora Jr., but in the end, heavy punches, especially to the body, paying huge dividends for the Russian.
Never stopped with that body assault, and finally it opened up the head where he kept putting on the pressure and gets the job done. And this was what's good for him is he had to dig down maybe four or five different levels to finally win this fight, and that's going to be good for Gassiev going forward.
Now, what I didn't understand, Dave, Johnny Callis stepped in between the two fighters. Murat Gassiev walked to the opposite corner, but then he didn't call anything.
Didn't call anything, and you have to either call the standing eight count or, yeah, but the standing eight count is not in effect. So that's a standing eight count moment. Then if you don't call the standing eight count, then you have to call off the fight, which he then did the next time.
Murat Gassiev improves his record to 21-0, 15 KOs. He is not signed by Roc Nation. But if Jay-Z is watching this fight right now, you need to sign this kid in a hurry before the other guys swoop in. He is talented. So let's take a look at the beginning of the end.
Gassiev, again, sensing that Cora had stopped. And he's right on him. Notice how he gives himself distance, gives himself room to punch, does not smother himself. Now, ordinarily you'd see a standing eight count here, but it's not in the rules. So he goes right back, and the referee seems to realize that, hey, I better get right back on top of this. It's the same thing, and he calls it.
Fatigue also a big factor for Felix Cora Jr. He was tired 35 years old, took a lot of punishment.
Guys who are squared up don't look as strong as that when they punch. Usually when you square up, you lose a lot of power. But Gassiev looks strong even that way.
Our main men standing by in Los Angeles. Let's go to the crazy Canadians, folks.
Jay and Dan.
All right. Thank you very much, guys. Terrific performance. A terrific night of boxing brought to you by Rock Nation Sports. Murat Gassiev records his 15th KO of his young career at 21 years old as we take a look at the official numbers.
Yep, all for Gassiev. Thrown, landed. That's a lot of punches thrown in that time. Nearly 100 punches around. It's very good for this division. He's above the division average, I would suspect. And the intensity of those body shots were terrific. Cora deserves a lot of credit for withstanding a lot of that.
So Murat Gassiev gaining valuable experience. That's his coach, Vitaly Slanov, who brought him up from the amateurs. Second assistant to Abel Sanchez.
We're talking about Abel Sanchez. That's Triple G, Carlos Baldemir, Sam Peter, Miguel Angel Gonzalez, and of course, he owns Big Bear, where all the fighters train.
Very smart businessman. Gassiev telling us in our fighter meeting this morning that he was happy to get out of the Los Angeles area and get to Big Bear, where it's tranquil. He can focus and train. Breathe in some of that good air.
And it's worked wonders for him. So Gassiev dominant in a good fight from the very start. And the theme, body punching. I mentioned earlier, he acted for a while like the head wasn't even allowed. Watch his hooks, watch the hips, the leverage, the timing, and the intensity. How quick and powerful these shots are. He doesn't waste anything. He was on top of Cora all night long. I'm impressed with 825 punches in this fight for a cruiserweight who is going to be a heavyweight. That is speed and power. Cora showed a lot of guts and determination in round 7. An explosion after he was nearly out. And then Gassiev turned the heat right back on him and was able to close the show. That's how we did it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time. 1:10 of round number 9. Referee Johnny Kalish stops this contest. Your winner by TKO victory and still the undefeated IBF Intercontinental Cruiserweight Champion, Murat Hiran Gassiev.
Murat Gassiev retains his IBF Intercontinental Cruiserweight title. The 21-year-old remains undefeated, 21-0 now with 15 KOs. Impressive performance. Remember this night, folks. This kid has a chance. For Dave Bontempo and our entire crew, Gus Johnson saying so long from Connecticut.